So thanks for doing this. So yesterday we talked a good deal about kind of the foundational, your origins within the labyrinth, and the continuity of the labyrinth, the sustainability of the labyrinth. And this is, you know, is it for a publication that's going to be celebrating the 20th anniversary. So this is your best chance, your most excellent opportunity to share with us your best insights about where the TLS has come in the last 18 years.
Well, it's a lot to absorb, it's a lot to remember, it's a lot to contemplate, and you know, from my own personal experience of the whole thing, it's a lot of energy to hold, and that's really how I see it in terms of my role in it. And the notion that it is so much bigger than any one individual, even bigger than the collective founding members, that small group of us that first came together, you know, to realize that we needed to create an organization to do what it was that one wonderful woman, Jean Lutz, tried to do single-handedly for 2 years, you know, on her own. And it was really due to her work that we all came together in the first place. So if it hadn't been for her inspiration in creating that first newsletter, we wouldn't have known who we all were. And so then the challenge I felt after leaving those first two gatherings that she put together, they were called conferences, was to do something that would maintain our ability to meet. I felt that very, very strongly. I just knew that we had to get together at least once a year. And so it was out of that sense of needing to meet with everybody that I called Robert Ferret and said, we need to meet. And he said, you're absolutely right. Why don't you come to St. Louis? Well, we know who we are. We'll gather everybody. And we met that first time in St. Louis with a small circle of, I think there were 24 of us. At that time, I had already created the Labyrinth Project of Connecticut, which was a 501c3 nonprofit. I was offering walks on a regular basis at the church in New Canaan, Connecticut. And so everybody said, well, look, Helen, you've done it once in Connecticut. Can't you make a similar corporation to hold the energy of something that's bigger and do it on a national basis? Well, it was soon apparent we were being called to do it on an international basis. We had people from England come to the next group, and so that's how it all got started. And it was quite an extraordinary time. And now here we are approaching 20 years later, and to think that the Labyrinth Society is still going so well. And I also feel as though the importance that all of us felt in terms of our roles, that we were just creating the beginnings of it, and that it was very important and necessary that we turn it over to new people as they came in. So every year new members of the board were added. My term as president, as founding president, only lasted for 5 years, and that was because Taffy Lanzer said the first year didn't count because we hadn't been incorporated yet. So we worked very, very hard and got it off the ground, and now we're on to our fifth president. And I think that turnover is so powerful and so important that we keep new energy coming in and new people interested and different perspectives and different points of view and, you know, different intentions, really, all within the big basket of wanting to support everyone who works with labyrinths without limitation or restriction.
That, there are two things that come to mind. One is, you mentioned in our other meeting about wanting implicitly that tolerance should be a basic understanding. It's like, yeah, the foundation on which this whole organization was to operate. Mm-hmm. And so I'd like to talk about that. And then I'd also like you to address how you felt when the first, well, then it was a conference, what later became the gatherings. Mm-hmm. When you first were called up on the stage to address people and welcome them to the first official TLS conference.
Even to this day, I can't ever be asked that question without putting myself back into that emotion. It comes comes up every single time because it's so powerful and so deeply ingrained. You know, it was not something that I had actually had a lot of time to think about in advance. We hadn't rehearsed anything. There was an agenda, but somebody said, well, Helen, you're the president, please go up on stage and welcome everybody. So I walked up on the stage and I looked out into this auditorium, this audience of, you know, well over 100 people. I think we must have had 150. And it just completely undid me. I mean, I became completely incapable of speaking. I was utterly overwhelmed and choking up. And it was the start of what happened then each year at the very beginning of the conference. I became famous for standing up there. And after the first time, everybody was throwing Kleenex packets at me and it became a thing, which, as you all know, I still do readily at a moment's notice to relive that incredible emotion of just knowing we've created something that's so big and so powerful. And then the second time it really hit me was, as I've told many times, getting on the plane to come home and buckling my seatbelt and thinking, if this plane goes down, there will still be Labyrinth Society. It's bigger than me, bigger than us, bigger than the board, bigger than the executive committee, bigger than any one person. And I just knew it would continue.
There's a great deal of power. There's a great deal of spirit. There's things that I'm new to experiencing here. But anecdotally, I'd like to know how you arranged for the organ music to accompany us this morning.
Oh, that was just the angels.
We
got that all solved before I got here.
I really hope that the microphone picks it up. So yesterday we did this, and let's do it again now. And that is, for the sake of posterity, is there anything else you want to share? Anything that we don't want to get on a plane this morning and go, oh man, I wish I would have said.
Oh, it's so hard. You asked me that yesterday, and coming up with one thing or one story is just, it's impossible. There's just too much. But, I guess just to reiterate how proud I am of what we've done and how proud I am of everybody coming along behind who's continued. And, what a difference I think we're making in the world. And that's the thing that's really the most important. Yeah. And the fact, as you say, that the intention was to be open to everybody who wishes to use the labyrinth to serve the wider labyrinth community in any way we can to be helpful to them without any judgment or criteria or certification or whatever in terms of limitations. So I think that was really key to what we knew we wanted to create in the beginning, and thank heavens it's still true today.
And it appears you've done just that.
I think so.
That's fabulous. That was 8 minutes.